Hey guys, welcome to this tutorial, and in this tutorial I'm gonna explain the step sequencer, what is this thing, in FL Studio. And the step sequencer is, when you play it you can make a sequence that sounds quite logic, which you can read also by creating drum rhythms. This is a very simple one, it's just kick and kick plus clap. And there are standard four sounds here, the kick, the clap, the hat and the snare. But you can even use your own samples, just click one and go to this thing here. And you can choose one from the standards in FL Studio, but of course this you can browse your whole computer to your own samples. You can even add a new one by doing a right mouse click, go to insert and go to audio clip. Which can alter audio clip. It don't have to be sampled. Could even be a wall a cappella or something. Now even your VST instrument such as Citrus does stand here. But it's not useful to programmate this one in a step sequencer. I would select them and go to the MIDI editor. You can select it with this buttons here. And just press this icon here to go to the MIDI editor. You can select multiply clips by using the your right mouse or using shift. That does both work. And these are the mute buttons, so you can mute wall tracks and volume buttons and panning between left and right. Now this is a play button, which is of course very useful. And here we can move it around, and this is the length of the pattern, because 8, that's the amount of beats. Who's there? And here you can select between patterns. I have only pattern 1 here, but you can browse between all your patterns. This, you can filter them. All you have all audio clips and VST instruments here, but you can only choose only audio clips or just unsorted. Well, I actually. And here you can swing, which you can make it like this. And I don't hear anything now. I don't know why. And of course. And with the right mouse click on a VST or audio clip, you can send it to the piano roll. Of course, now you have a drum rhythm in piano roll, what I quite hate. Delete it. Oh, of course, there's nothing in this audio clip, because that's why I don't hear anything. And you can also load a new sample here, set the icon for it. You can color or rename here. Edit, just basic operations. Insert another one which I already showed, replace it by something, clone it or delete it. If you don't want this kick, you can just delete it and it's out of your whole track. That's are the basics. Here I can use some effects, parse, sequence. So I want the velocity of the second sequence. If you have this, this is not sample loaded, but this velocity would be higher, and this one you won't hear anything. That's quite useful. And you can also do this with panning and release and modulate X and modulation Y and fine pitch and shift. So a lot of things. And this is the pitch of the sample. I quite hate this menu because it's so little to choose the right one. Now that's the basic of the step sequencer. I hope you like my tutorial, and I'll check you later in another tutorial. Bye. Please like, subscribe and share.